execution by firing squad, in the past sometimes called fusillading, from the French fusil rifle, is a method of capital punishment, particularly common in the military and in times of war. Execution by shooting is a fairly old practice. Some reasons for its use are that firearms are usually readily available and a gunshot to a vital organ, such as the brain or heart, most often will kill relatively quickly. A firing squad is normally composed of several military personnel, all of whom are usually instructed to fire simultaneously, thus preventing both disruption of the process by one member and identification of the member who fired the lethal shot. To avoid disfigurement due to multiple shots to the head, the shooters are typically instructed to aim at the heart, sometimes aided by a paper target. The prisoner is typically blindfolded or hooded, as well as restrained, although in some cases prisoners have asked to be allowed to face the firing squad without their eyes covered. Media portrayals have frequently shown the condemned being offered a final cigarette as well. Executions can be carried out with the condemned either standing or sitting. There is a tradition in some jurisdictions that such executions are carried out at first light or at sunrise. This gave rise to the phrase shot at dawn. What led to the double execution by firing squad of Verne Alfred Braasch and Melvin Leroy Sullivan? Verne Alfred Braasch and Melvin Leroy Sullivan were convicted of first-degree murder of Howard Manzioni, a Standard Oil Service station attendant, at Beaver City, Utah, on October 22, 1949, and were sentenced to death. At the time of the killing, Braasch was 24 years of age and Sullivan 19. The day after the killing, both were arrested in Las Vegas, Nevada, where each made both oral and written confessions without the aid or advice of counsel. On October 25th, they were taken before a committing magistrate at Beaver City, and a preliminary hearing was held with their assent without being represented by an attorney. Thereafter, on the same day, they reenacted the shooting at the service station, and prior to the trial, each made additional statements, some of them after they had consulted counsel. By their confessions, the defendants each stated that they went to Beaver to commit robbery, that they went to the Standard Oil Company's station armed with 22 caliber pistols for that purpose and, pursuant to their plans, Braasch attempted to strike the attendant from behind over the head with his cocked pistol, when the attendant grabbed Braasch, who shot him through the back. And struggling, they went to the floor together. Thereupon Sullivan shot the attendant high in the arm, and when he released his grip, Braasch arose and as they fled without taking the money, each shot the attendant through the head as he lay on the floor. They stated that they went south on Highway 91, and as they crossed the Beaver River, they threw their guns over the side of the bridge. And later they flagged a Greyhound bus traveling south and took it to Cedar City, where they remained until early the next morning when they took a bus to Las Vegas. On the 22nd of October 1949, during an early morning robbery of a Standard service station in Beaver, Utah, Verne Alfred Braasch and Melvin Leroy Sullivan shot and killed the attendant, Howard W. Manzioni, 1 hour before the end of his shift. He was shot 4 times and died after being transported to the Cedar City Hospital. Tried and sentenced 4 times to die, they survived each execution date until 1956. They held the record at the time for being the longest on Utah's death row. They spent 6 years on death row. The process and the expense became so frustrating to Governor J. Bracken Lee that he submitted a bill to the U.S. Department of Justice for $19,685 to $615 per month. With all appeals exhausted, Braasch and Sullivan released a statement to the press shortly before their execution. "Inasmuch as we have only a few hours more to live, we wish to make a public statement. First, we do not protest against being punished. We are found guilty of a serious crime. In the second place, we wish to say, in partial excuse for ourselves, that we did not have a fair chance in life. Coming from broken homes, we grew up in neglect. In youth, we were denied parental care, affection and guidance. Religious training would have pointed us in the right direction, but we were not taken to Sunday school or to church services. While in prison during the long years of waiting, we have tried to build up in our souls what was lacking. We now try to accept our severe punishment with true religious resignation." Braasch and Sullivan ate their last meal of roast pheasant, green salad, and strawberries and cream. The warden in his memo authorizing the last meal also ordered 1 pint each of dry wine and sweet wine to be shared between the inmates. Theirs was a double execution, the second in Utah's history. The first was that of Antelope and Long Hair in 1854. The two chairs were placed on a sled-type apparatus. Sandbags were placed behind the chairs and wood shavings covered the floor. 2 chairs were used, one black, which had been used for other executions, and one white, newly painted. Sullivan sat in the black one, Braasch in the white. The execution was conducted by the sheriff of Iron County, where the trial had been held. The trial had been changed from Beaver County because it was feared an impartial trial could not be conducted in the county where the crime occurred. The sheriff placed his hat over his heart, thus signaling the 2 separate firing squads to do their work. Both men were pronounced dead within 1 minute of the shots. The barking rifles of 10 volunteer marksmen ended a 6.5-year battle by Verne Alfred Braasch and Melvin Leroy Sullivan. Thank you for watching Death Row.